call for young people to commit to the development of CSME. Heavy rain results in stalled cars and gridlock. And in sports, the West Indies coach suspended ahead of the tour to Sri Lanka.
Credible, balanced, committed. This is the CBC Evening News.
Very good evening to you. I'm Lisa Broom. This is the CBC Evening News. The CARICOM single market and economy is not functioning at its fullest capacity. But to ensure it does, Acting Prime Minister Richard Seely says the youth need to commit it to its development. Mr. Seely was speaking to students from Antigua and Barbuda who are engaging in the field promotion of the CARICOM Secretariat with the assistance of the European Union's 10th EDF CSME and Economic Integration Programme.
CARICOM nationals.
Misunderstood and unappreciated by our young people. It is therefore the responsibility of the leaders of this region to develop initiatives aimed at empowering and positioning young people to take advantage of and contribute to regional integration and the CSME. The views of the youth are indeed integral in determining how we proceed with the further development of the single market and economy.
In the program, there are 19 students ages 17 to 34 and one youth ambassador. Minister Seely reminded the students that the visit will expose them to various organizations, such as the Central Bank of Barbados, which plays a role in CSME.
If we don't accept and recognize that for the region to truly deal with its problems, the vexing problems at the social and economic level, we are going to have to work together as a region and accord solutions to the problems that exist.
Also addressing the youngsters was Barbados' ambassador to CARICOM, Robert Morris. He's of the view that a CARICOM certificate plan needs to be implemented. Ambassador Morris says as there is an increase in free movement, the integration movement needs to be made easier for the youth as they pursue their dreams.
As we seek to implement the CARICOM Strategic Plan 2015 to 2019, metrics will be applied to examine the extent to which free movement is being practiced. At the end of the period, it's not just an exercise that we're doing. We have to measure. We have to look back and see what have we actually done. In my view, our legislatures will ensure that the legal requirements are put in place, and our bureaucrats will ensure that administrative measures are implemented. There must be ongoing educational activities to ensure that the would-be movers are encouraged to follow their dreams, and the receivers are sensitized to extend welcoming arms to our brothers and sisters.
Ambassador Michael Barford, head of the European Union delegation to Barbados and the Eastern Caribbean, has put forward some suggestions to expand the integration.
Moving on from the student exchange missions to scale it up to a more complete program like the Erasmus, that would turn it into a Caribbean Erasmus program in a sense. Under the 11th EDF Caribbean Indicative Program, which covers a total envelope of 346 million euros, strengthening of universities' networks appear amongst the actions to be contemplated. Again, we need this should give you some food for thought.
A deluge caused gridlock on some of the major roads in the city and around Barbados today. The flooding caused some motorists to turn around and find alternate routes. Some, however, braved the rising water and were able to speed through. Others, though, were not so lucky. They stalled and had to abandon their vehicles. Government advisor on social policy, Hamilton Lashley, who lives in Halls Road, tells CBC News around 3 o'clock residents were faring the worst as a result of the flooding.
Do you know this area is prone to flooding? It has a history of flooding dating back to 1948, but it got bad to the point where some vehicles were stranded on their way going towards the Globe Lake from cross by the hospital to the Grove in that area, and it was, you know, the water was clear because if it had came over the bank there, obviously with the flood back into the gaps, therefore threatening residents. It had subsided somewhat, and I'm hoping that for the rest of the evening we don't have any more rain in the area, but it certainly was a clear, at that time it presented a very clear and present danger at the time.
The case of Unity Workers Union on behalf of Leo Graham and the Rural Development Commission got underway today at the offices of the Labour Ministry in Warrens. The case will seek to address claims by Leo Graham that he was unfairly dismissed on May 13, 2013 from the Rural Development Commission when his contract of temporary employment was terminated without reason. Mr. Graham contends that his termination was in breach of Sections 26 and 29 of the Employment Rights Act. He's therefore seeking compensation, reasons for dismissal, reinstatement, and or re-engagement, as well as a request that the tribunal consider issuing costs. The Rural Development Commission is, however, claiming that in keeping with the terms of Mr. Graham's contract of employment, he could lawfully be terminated as long as he was given at least 1 month's notice. Leo Graham is represented by attorneys Gregory Nichols and Oliver Thomas, while Mitchell Codrington represents the Rural Development Commission. BHP Billington has been revealing its plans for the coming 3 years. Among the projects, oil exploration in Barbadian waters. Barbados and the Australian firm signed 2 exploration licenses to search for oil off the island in 2 blocks, Carlisle Bay and Bimshire, earlier this year. President Petroleum BHP Billington, Tim Cutt, provided some insight into the projects during the recently held 2015 Barclays CEO Energy Power Conference. He said the company's exploration strategy focuses on areas where there will be returns.
With focus on the Western Gulf of Mexico. Over the past 12 months, we've acquired 50 blocks, including the recent sale, which is subject to customary approval. In the Caribbean, we have built a substantial first-mover acres position totaling approximately 17,000 square kilometers across 2 plays, the Oligocene and the Miocene, in Trinidad and Tobago and Barbados. This is 4 times the size of our substantial Gulf of Mexico portfolio. In Western Australia, we have accessed a dominant position totaling approximately 25,000 square kilometers over the largely untested Beagle Subbasin. Over the next 3 years, we will test these 3 plays with the drill bit.
After an outcry from monthly paid workers at the National Union of Public Workers about not receiving their salaries, the latest news is that they have been paid. A worker confirmed it to CBC this evening. The just over 12 monthly paid workers were threatening strike action after not receiving their September salaries last Friday. Reports are that the treasurer and his deputy were both overseas, and efforts to rectify the situation then were unsuccessful. Now, when contacted earlier today, NUPW General Secretary Rosalind Smith said the problem was caused by a miscommunication. She said the issue was resolved this morning and workers should be paid today. Barbados has been identified as an example for Guyana to follow with respect to the development of solar energy. As experts continue to debate whether that country should place greater emphasis on hydro or solar electricity, a top government advisor on the environment and a solar energy company are pushing the benefits of photovoltaic power to the new David Granger-led administration. Presidential advisor on the environment, retired Rear Admiral Gary Best, said large and small solar energy producers can use photovoltaic power in the day and fossil fuel in the night. He acknowledged it would be expensive for a domestic user, but notes the long-term benefit is exceptionally good. Meanwhile, the Barbados-based Solaris Energy is hoping to cash in on the renewable energy market in Guyana. Sales manager Carlton DeFore said Guyana is ideally located very close to the equator, has 12 hours of sunlight daily, as well as large remote land areas not served by the Guyana Power and Light Company. DeFore said no talks have been held with the Guyana government, but the company is willing to meet with the authorities. Local lawmen are tonight investigating reports of a schoolgirl posing with a gun on social media site Facebook. Acting Public Relations Officer, Station Sergeant Roland Cobbler, told CBC News the matter was brought to the attention of the force today and they're looking into it. Police say reports suggest the girl was posing in a secondary school uniform. We'll have more news in just a moment, but first we want to get your take on this question. Do you think West Indies coach Phil Simmons should have been suspended for his criticism of the team selected? Text yes or no to short code 8111. We'll have the results for you at the end of the news.
Sandals, sandals, sandals galore. Megville gives you ladies sandals for this week only. Monday to Saturday, any pair of sandals for only $25. So go to Megville on Tudor Street, High Street and Palmetto Street for any pair of sandals for only $25. This week only, Monday to Saturday.
It's the flavor that's loved by almost everyone, and everyone should be free to enjoy it. That's why Baico is introducing Diabetic Delight in delicious chocolate flavor. So go on, indulge yourself in this guilt-free and healthy choice. Baico Diabetic's Delight ice cream is also available in mango, vanilla, and strawberry from retail stores, Baico Mobilers, and the Baico Direct outlet.
Pananan's house, a Bajan favorite. But remember, like all other foods, it should be stored at the correct temperature. Enjoy your pudding and sauce safely by following these general tips. Never leave cooked foods at room temperature for more than 2 hours. Keep the pudding at a hot holding temperature of above 60 degrees Celsius and the sauce at a cold temperature of below 5 degrees Celsius. Promptly refrigerate all cooked and perishable foods.
Hi, I'm Red Plastic Bag. Anyone who knows me knows I don't like cold. Sunshine reigns in my country. I love it.
Get your sun power.
Local musical production City Nights is back and promises to be even more special this year. That's according to manager of the Frank Cullimore Hall, Fran Wickham, during a press conference to launch the event. She says it runs October 10th and 11th and will feature an outstanding lineup of artists led by Nicholas Branker and including Biggie Irie and Edwin. Ms. Wickham says the show will also continue to focus on the development of youth in music.
Every year we have several shows, which we call our Sunset Concerts. We give the opportunity to young upcoming talent to perform to our local public and by extension our visitors to the island. For this show, we'd love for persons to come out, support the arts, support our local talent. For those visitors to the island, this is an opportunity to see La creme de la creme on our stage.
And headline act Nicholas Branker says he's excited about the opportunity to be on a local stage.
I have been fortunate to be touched by some of the greatest musical minds in the world. I have also been fortunate enough to grow up in an environment where there were people of my age who had similar interests that we could all grow together. And I've also been fortunate enough to live in a society where there is a group of people coming after me who are finding it fit to benefit from my advice and my track record. I hope to bring all of those things together in this performance.
Well, it was a warm welcome for the new divisional commanders of the Salvation Army, Majors Sinus and Marie Theodore. The husband and wife were officially installed during a ceremony at Solidarity House. They had served as divisional leaders in Guyana and Trinidad and Tobago before returning to Barbados a year ago as divisional officers for Business Administration and Women's Ministries, respectively. MP for the City of Bridgetown, Lieutenant Colonel Jeffrey Bostick, says Major Sinus and Marie Theodore are assuming duties at a time when Barbados is facing some significant challenges.
You'll find that the traditional support which is required of you as the Salvation Army to those vulnerable people in our society will probably be greater now than at any other time in the history of our nation.
As the month of the elderly comes to a close, senior citizens around the island are still being showed how much they are appreciated. In this latest initiative, the Lions Club of St. Michael treated several of them to a tea party and gave them gifts. There was also a serious side to the evening as the National Union of Public Workers Horatio Cook Auditorium, where the party was held, as the older folk were given a talk on fire safety. President of the club, Indra Skeet, says the effort is part of the club's mandate to serve the community. Another primary school is helping out the children of Dominica who were affected by Tropical Storm Erica. The Charles F. Broome Primary held a dollar drive in an effort to collect enough money to buy stationery for the hundreds of children affected by the storm. Principal Monica Walton tells CBC News she's pleased with the effort.
This year, we are also celebrating our school's 40th anniversary. And what we have decided to do as part of one of our celebratory events is to have our students bring a dollar to purchase stationery items for the students in Dominica so that as they get themselves ready for school, they would have some of the needed supplies that are required.
And two of the students who we spoke to encouraged others to do the same.
We feel very happy right now today with our fundraiser to you, Dominica.
I would like to encourage the other children around Barbados to donate this dollar to Dominica and supplies.
And organizations still wishing to donate relief supplies to the Commonwealth of Dominica are asked to deliver the items to the Barbados Coast Guard HMBS Pelican, Spring Garden, St. Michael, tomorrow between the hours of 9 a.m. and 3 p.m. The items are to be boxed or neatly packaged and clearly labeled with the name, address, and contact number of the organization or person to whom the items are to be delivered. A list of the items being donated should also accompany the packages. Please note that items in plastic or paper bags will not be accepted. Still to come, we have a look at some of the stories making headlines across the region. But first, a reminder that we want to hear from you on this question. Do you think West Indies coach